Everyone remembers Dumbo.
Oh, I remember.
Of all the countless Disney animated films that could be adapted into live action, Dumbo is sort of a surprising one for me. The original film, while a big hit in its own day and hugely important to the history of the Walt Disney Company, see more on that up here, is very much a product of the early 20th century and in many ways incongruent with modern sensibilities. For one thing, it's only 63 minutes long, so right out the gate, you know there's gonna have to be tons of padding to get it out to standard feature length. Meanwhile, of the original Dumbo's two most famous scenes, one is now considered by many to be offensive, while the other essentially amounts to an on-screen reenactment of a toddler suffering the effects of LSD.
You see what I see?
Going into this movie, I thought I had it pegged down to just be another generic, lazy Disney remake, but guys, I'll be the first to admit when I'm wrong about something, and I really have to say that I was completely blown away by just how f***ing terrible this new Dumbo movie is. No word of a lie, this is by far the worst and most painful to sit through of these things that I've seen yet. Dumbo 2019 is directed by Tim Burton and written by Aaron Kruger, best known for his work on Transformers 2, 3, and 4. The film stars Colin Farrell, Danny DeVito, Eva Green, Michael Keaton, and Johnny Depp as, no, not really, but there is a CGI elephant in the room, I guess. The film isn't really about him, though. Dumbo's character is so de-emphasized in this movie that he's really more of a plot device than anything else. Instead, the story mostly revolves around Danny DeVito, Colin Farrell, and Colin Farrell's two kids, neither of whom are played by very good actors. Even if Dumbo was in more of the film, however, the CGI isn't great by today's standards. His character model is way less expressive than it was in the cartoon, and as a result, it's harder to feel bad for him or even take him seriously as a screen presence. In fact, almost everything cartoony about the original has either been de-emphasized or removed completely, which is a baffling decision to me since even back in 1941, Dumbo was more of a self-aware, silly cartoon adventure than its contemporaries, but this remake is eager to distance itself from all of that.
I loved the original version. This is a new, modern take on it.
The most you ever get are these little Easter eggs calling back to some of the original's more iconic moments, but they're so brief and superfluous and given so little context or importance that anyone who hasn't already seen the original will have no idea what they're doing there. Why does that train have a weird creepy face? Why is that one mouse wearing clothes in a cage with other mice that aren't wearing clothes? Why do we keep cutting to storks? What the f*** is up with this weird circus act where the guy blows giant elephant-shaped bubbles that dance around? Then of course there's the magic feather, a placebo given to Dumbo in the original film by the crow characters that makes him confident enough to fly. Well, of course, there are no crow characters in this film, so at the beginning of the movie, Dumbo accidentally inhales a feather and then he sneezes, and that's the first time he jumps in the air and flaps around, so now for some reason he thinks he needs the feather to fly. Okay.
He won't fly without a feather.
The only fantastical aspect of the story that's left intact is the basic premise, which should have been some sort of clue to the filmmakers what kind of story they're telling here. Like, yeah, this thing with the elephant that flaps his giant ears like wings to fly around sounds pretty cool, but does it really need to have talking animals? That's just silly. There is a silly monkey, though. The monkey is allowed to do silly things because he's a monkey, and monkeys are silly.
Is that a monkey in your desk?
Even the movie's color palette genuinely feels like everyone involved was doing their best to make sure it was as desaturated, ugly, and murky looking as possible. So much so that half the time the sky looks like it's in sepia, a stark contrast to the bright and vibrant world of the original. So many of the details from this already short story are cut from this remake that it reaches the original endpoint of the story by the 35-minute mark.
The original ends with the elephant flying, and this version begins with that.
The new modern take on it.
From there, it goes off on an extremely boring and cliche plot where this greedy businessman played by Michael Keaton wants to exploit Dumbo to get rich.
Made me a child again.
So Colin Farrell and Eva Green and all of Dumbo's other circus buddies need to team up and save him and his mother from captivity, turning the movie into Free Willy at the last second. Then Danny DeVito's heart grows three sizes that day, and he announces that there will no longer be any captive animals featured at this circus. Except 2 seconds later, Colin Farrell rides out on a horse and starts having it do tricks, so I don't know. I guess there were a few things I kinda liked, though. As with most Tim Burton films, the production design, props, and costumes all look pretty good. If I haven't already gotten my point across here, let me just spell it out. This movie is absolute trash. I feel bad for having seen it, and I don't even have a particularly strong attachment to the original, aside from general admiration and respect for its role in cinematic history. It's pretty sad to me that this classic film, responsible in its day for saving Disney from the brink of destruction, is now being cynically remade almost 80 years later as what essentially amounts to cinematic shovelware dumped onto the market to try and fill the box office gap between How to Train Your Dragon 3 and Aladdin. Hard pass.
Fly,
you fools.
No! If you like this video though, you'd be doing me a huge favor if you could hit that like button, subscribe for more in the future, and ring the bell to stay up to date on future releases. Leave a comment down below letting me know all of your thoughts on anything I've talked about in this video, and check out some of the other stuff I've got up here on the screen. As always, thanks so much to all of you guys once again for watching, and take care.
The new modern take on it.